Hi everyone. Hi Supriya. Thank you so much for agreeing to do this with me today. So for those of you who are new here, I'm Riya, and today I have with me Supriya, who's from the EPGP program of IIM Bangalore, which is the executive postgraduate program. And before coming to IIM Bangalore, even I had not heard about this program. So when we became friends, I decided to interview her so that more people know about this program. And introducing Supriya briefly, she's done her engineering, then she worked in the aviation industry for 7+ years and then decided to go ahead with an MBA, an executive MBA. And post this 1-year program, she's going to be joining as a product manager now. So we'll hear more of her story from her. And yeah, let's get to know her and the program and anything else. We will talk a lot. So yeah, I gave a short introduction, Supriya, but can you please take us through your journey, your educational journey, and how did it end up at IIM Bangalore?
Okay, thank you Riya for having me here. So hey everyone, again, I'm Supriya. I'm currently part of 1-year MBA program at IIM Bangalore. So this program goes by the name EPGP at IIM Bangalore. So this is 1-year full-time residential program for people with experience. So to be eligible for this program, you need to have minimum 5 years of experience, and then you have to write GMAT, and the rest of the application process remains the same as 2-year MBA program, wherein you have to write statement of purpose, you have to get letter of recommendations, you have to write written assessment test, and then you have face-to-face interview. So now, how did I choose this program, right? So I always wanted to do MBA at some point in my career, and I always wanted to do full-time MBA program. So when I completed 6 years of my corporate journey, I wanted to transition from engineering to business side of the things. And that's when I got to know about this 1-year program at IIM Bangalore, and it is being also offered by other premium institutes in India as well. So it sounded like a great opportunity, and it was exactly the thing that I was looking for my future transition. And yeah, I decided to prepare for it, gave my GMAT, and started working on the application.
Yeah. So at what time did you hear about it? When is the time when the applications are open for this program? What is the rough average required GMAT score, if you can give us the numbers?
Yeah, sure. So the admission happens across 3 rounds. So the first round opens approximately, I think, the deadline is in June for the first round. For the second round, it varies actually by a month or so. But for the year wherein I applied, the deadline for second round was in September. And the deadline for the third round wherein I applied, it was towards December. And as far as GMAT score is concerned, it is not really a cutoff. So it varies every year. Mm-hmm. So approximate range for GMAT score for this program is from 630 to 780. Mm-hmm. And again, it is not the cutoff. So if you have, you know, experience in leadership, in your previous experience, and if you do really well in your interview, in your written assessment test, and you get a great letter of recommendations from your previous employers, so you can compensate with all this with your low GMAT score. So that's absolutely okay. You have you still have a good chance to get through this application.
Yeah. Wow. Yeah. And then the batch starts in April, roughly, is it?
So this program typically starts towards end of March, and it's 1-year program. So we are just done with our final exam. So our convocation is due on
March to March.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you walk us through the curriculum, the terms or modules that you call them, and also mention about the international immersion, which is, I think, the a mandatory part of this program at IIMB.
Yeah. Okay. So if you see the number of subjects that we have to study, it is exactly the same as for you guys.
PGP.
Yeah. Just the timeline is 1 year. So it is really, really intense. So this 1 year is divided into 5 terms, wherein we have first 2 terms as core subjects, wherein we learn the foundation of the business. We study corporate finance, corporate governance and ethics, strategy, macroeconomics, etc. And then the third term is international immersion. Yes, it is mandatory for the EPGP batch, wherein we go to MBA institutes abroad. So this year we went to ESCP Berlin and ESCP Madrid, and half of our batch went to Solvay Business School in Brussels. So we get a chance to learn about international markets, learn business in that country, and also the cultural aspect of it. Now, in the last two terms, those are dedicated for our electives. Mm-hmm. So you get a chance to handpick electives as per your interest and aspirations for the future. Yeah.
Wow. So you study both the fundamental subjects of a business school. Yeah. You go for international immersion. Yeah. Plus electives, very right. much like the PGP program.
Yes.
Okay. After academics, the second most important thing is placements. Mm-hmm. And because you say that it's for people above 5 years of work, it's mm-hmm. the role that they get out of MBA is even more important for them because they have so much at stake.
Yeah.
So what kind of people, what jobs are people looking for after EPGP program? Mm-hmm. What are their aspirations like? Mm-hmm. What kind of roles are available? Mm-hmm. If you can throw some light on the placements of the EPGP program.
Okay. So typically people come here with a couple of goals in their mind. So the first one would be some people want to move up the ladder vertically in the same company. Mm-hmm. So there were a few batchmates of mine who were sponsored candidates from their respective companies. And mm-hmm. after completing this program, they would go back into the same organization and move up the ladder. Secondly, there are a few people who want to change the function. For example, there are a few people who worked in, let's say, marketing, and they mm-hmm. want to move into consulting. Mm-hmm. So that is totally possible after this program. And lastly, there are a few people who want to change their industry. Mm-hmm. So that is, again, very much possible. So some people want to move from, let's say, automotive to healthcare. So there are a few transferable skills that you carry, and that too coupled with the business acumen that you get out of this program. So that opens a lot of avenues for such transitions. And I have seen a lot of transitions happen within our batch and also with our seniors as well. And I'm definitely happy with mine. So,
and yeah. I would really like you to tell our audience your personal story, how you are going to be shifting from the aviation industry to a broadman.
Yeah, okay. So, as Riya said, I'm a mechanical engineer. So, through and through my career, I worked on aerospace components. So, I have had experience as product manager, but in the aerospace ecosystem. Mm-hmm. And I wanted to move into digital domain, but wanted to keep my function same. So, I wanted to be working on products, but the third type, as I said, changing the mm-hmm. industry. So, although I will be joining the travel industry, so I have worked in some part of value chain previously. So, my first company was Eaton Technology, where I worked on components, fuel components that are used in the aircraft. Mm-hmm. Later on, with Airbus, I worked on system side. I worked from the customer side. And now I am moving up to the value chain. Now I will be working from a company who are responsible for digitalization of all the travel space that you see. So, mm-hmm. yeah, I'm really excited about it. So I'm keeping my function same, just the change of industry. Yeah.
Wow. And I hope it turns out to be just the way you've thought of it.
Yeah, hope so.
Yeah. Now, coming apart from academics and placements, mm-hmm. there is so much to MBA life. And now that the EPGP batch have become a residential program, you get to live with all the facilities, the events, fests. How has that been like for you? And also, I want to mention that Supriya has been living with her partner on campus. So, can you also tell us how accommodative was IIMB Bangalore with providing proper accommodation? Mm-hmm. And yeah, how has your experience been apart from academics and placements?
Okay. In this 1 year, apart from academics, there are so many things to do on campus. Be it co-curricular activities. So there are many seminar series that happen as part of our program. And also there are many other events. For example, we had BizCon. And it is not only limited to organizing from EPGP cohort. We also participate in PGP events. So there is a lot of synergies that is happening between many programs mm-hmm. across IIMB Bangalore. And that is really amazing part. And apart from that, IIMB Bangalore is known for its sports culture, right? So a lot of people from my batch actually participated in a lot of sports. So I think the highlight of the sports this year was cricket team. And one of my batchmates was actually the captain of cricket team at IIMB Bangalore. And many people took advantage of this great avenue that we have at IIMB Bangalore. And apart from that, on a personal level, yes, IIMB Bangalore has been accommodative, wherein we can actually stay with our spouse on campus. So ours is 15th batch, and we are the lucky ones to actually stay on the campus for the first time. So we have a dedicated hostel for EPGP, and it is, you know, double occupancy, wherein you can bring your partner and stay with them. So personally, I enjoyed this journey so much, and this is the most beautiful campus that I have ever seen. So yeah, it has literally been the most beautiful journey for me.
And the spouses also get to use all the facilities, right?
Yes, yes.
So they have a proper vacation. Staycation, actually.
Staycation, yes.
If they have remote work, they can live here and work.
So. Yeah. It's actually a running joke wherein we say this is the best resort that one can have.
I certainly.
Yeah.
Okay. So now that both our MBAs are almost over, I ask this question to everyone I meet. Mm-hmm. What has been your biggest takeaway from this MBA journey?
Okay, well, there are so many takeaways. I think the first lesson that I learned in this program is time management. I think you would definitely agree to this. There are just so many things that you want to do. Like, that's the effect of FOMO, right? Like, there are so many events that are happening. You want to party, you want to study, you want to do case competitions, and you want to participate in sports. So we had to really manage so many things at the same time. And I think I'm a little better at time management at the end of the journey. So that was one key learning that I had. And apart from that, I think I realized the importance of having diverse set of people around you. So our batch is of 75 people with so many different backgrounds. So we had people from automotive, aviation, energy, oil and gas, people were from HR, hospitality, army, medical profession, and the list goes on and on. One of our batchmates, he was a scientist at Bark. So like, imagine the kind of discussions you can have with so diverse people in the class and off the class, of course. So all those discussions have actually helped me learn more from this program. So mm-hmm. that is going to stay with me on much deeper level. Mm-hmm. That was another having diverse set of people around you. And I have firsthand experienced the importance of having diverse set of people through the group projects and group assignment that we have mm-hmm. as part of our curriculum. And lastly, being comfortable with not knowing all the information that you need to make decisions. Because as engineers, we are hardwired to see world in binary terms, right? So like, through all the case studies that we have studied here, all the discussions that have happened as part of seminar series and guest lecture series that we have here, we have understood that the business world will not be black and white. It will be mostly gray for the most of the time. And you have to make use of the available information, have the best assumptions in hand and make the decisions and then learn and adapt. So that's another key learning that I have with me, and hopefully I'll apply in my next journey.
Certainly. Yeah. And all three of your realizations resonate with me also. I've learned to manage my time better. I know what to prioritize, what to say no to,
exactly.
and how to do the 10 things in my day that I want to. Mm-hmm. Second, yes, you learn so much from the diverse cohort that you have. You see, this is another perspective that I have not thought about. Accepting uncertainty and yet being able to take the best decision that you can with the limited information.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Okay. So, Supriya, do you have any regrets or anything that you would have done differently?
Regrets, I don't know. But if I had to do certain thing differently, I would say, take less stress in mm-hmm. the first few terms, because we have worked in the industry for quite certain time. You kind of tend to lose the touch with academics and you overcompensate it with studying a lot. But I think that was the key learning as a batch over this 1 year, that learning does not only happen theoretically. There are many aspects of learning, especially in the MBA program, wherein we have case study methodology of teaching, right? So I think getting your hands dirty in the group assignment and projects, that's the best learning that I have had here. So mm-hmm. I think I would say to year older version of myself, mm-hmm. to take less stress and mm-hmm. learn more outside the classroom, be out there and talk to people and mm-hmm. just learn from people.
Not be so competitive.
Yeah.
Run less behind marks and take it as a whole-rounded self-development program.
Exactly. I mean, you are here to actually unlearn many things than learn new things. I would say that's the best advice that one can give to junior batches, that just let go of, you know, previous preconceived notion that you really have to study hard. I think mm-hmm. you need to study smart and get most of this program.
Absolutely. Yeah. That's what MBA is in short. So, I'm sure apart from these academic learnings mm-hmm. and way of thinking, has there been any personal change that you've seen in yourself, the personal transformation that we talk about, mm-hmm. any growth that you've seen internally within yourself, and would you want to share it?
I had envisioned a version of myself, what would I like to become at the end of the journey. Mm-hmm. So I think I am way more confident than what I was a year back. I have, you know, all the necessary tools and frameworks that are needed in order to take up the roles in business world. Mm-hmm. So I'm pretty much confident on that aspect. The key change that I see in myself is, you know, I have now multiple lenses to look at things. So I'm able to decipher things really well, especially in terms of business. I think that is key change that I am seeing for myself, not seeing the news as is, but to really understand what is behind the scene for this outcome.
Yes, this happens with me also. I see anything about the interest rate or the stock market and I'm like, okay, maybe this is because of this, or the government has this in mind.
Definitely.
Absolutely can relate to this point as well.
So another important thing that I have learned during this journey is, power of networking. It does not only mean that you should go and talk to people, but it also helps you enrich your learning. So, because as I said, we had a lot of diversity in our batch. Mm-hmm. I was able to, talk to almost everyone through this 1 year, actually sit with them and talk to them. And that really helped me gain learnings on a personal level that I spoke about unlearning part, right? Mm-hmm. So, when you meet more brilliant, more intelligent and smarter people than you, you kind of also introspect that, this is how people actually think, and maybe I can change certain way of thinking. So I think that happens with the power of networking. So that is another thing that I really practiced this year, and it does not only limit to knowing people from your class, but across the branches,
batches, courses.
So like IIMB Bangalore actually has a lot of different programs wherein we have 2 year program, 1 year program, then we have people with more experienced on the campus. You just have to go and meet people and talk to them, so there is so much to learn through networking.
And also not just classrooms. I think I've spoken to most people in the mess. Like sometimes I just sit alone and someone would just drop by on my table, or I go and sit to someone's table and we've had craziest discussions. And I feel those are the sessions where I've bonded with people the most. Like it was the case with us. She randomly dropped in a message. We had lunch or breakfast once or twice. And then it felt like, wow, I connect with this person. I would love to talk to this person more. Don't know how it'll end up for us, like in the a professional relationship, mm-hmm. if we'll be of any help to each other or not going forward, but who knows.
I utilize my time in networking so much that my classmates actually call me social butterfly. Mm-hmm. So,
why? Because you go knock doors and you're like, let's talk? Or?
No, I mean, I just enjoy talking to people, new people, and just, having the conversation. I really love it to know what they're doing and their background. Mm. And I think that's how we also.
And you don't know, just a random question can go into 2 hour long discussion and you feel so connected to the person after the conversation.